Hey everyone, welcome to the Planet Earth channel. Today we're diving into the world of wombats. Who, you ask? Wombats. To meet them, we'll travel to Australia, where this truly fascinating creature awaits us. A peaceful little fellow with no ties to the military, despite what his name might suggest. But dig a bit deeper, like wombats do, and you'll find some surprising facts. So let's go. Wombats are mostly found on the Australian continent. They belong to the marsupial family and the order of diprotodonts. They feed mainly on plants and live in burrows, which they dig themselves. Visually, they look a bit like tiny bears, or maybe like oversized hamsters. According to scientists, wombats are descendants of diprotodons, the largest known marsupial to ever walk the earth. Diprotodon was part of Australia's so-called megafauna, a group of giant, often bizarre animals that roamed the continent millions of years ago. Today, only two wombat species remain from that ancient family, the short-haired wombat and the long-haired or Queensland wombat. Wombats are classic herbivores. On average, they grow up to about 1 meter long and weigh around 30 kilograms. They're known for their compact yet sturdy build. They have relatively small bodies, large heads, and short but powerful limbs. Their tails are tiny and, according to scientists, underdeveloped. Although who are they to judge? They don't even have tails. Wombat fur is usually gray or ash colored. Now where is the wombat's tail? Right where everyone's is, in on its butt. And that butt is its pride and joy. The wombat's rear has a unique structure, a thick shield of bones and cartilage covered in tough skin. This butt shield acts as natural armor. If a predator tries to sneak into a wombat burrow, the wombat blocks the entrance by sitting in it, presenting the enemy with a solid wall of wombat booty. Since the rear is tougher and heavier than the front, wombats can even use it as a weapon. Need to squish an intruder? No problem. The last thing a predator sees might be that famously underdeveloped tail waving goodbye. Despite their stubby legs, wombats can run up to 40 kilometers per hour. They can also climb trees and swim quite well. Their jaws and teeth resemble those of rodents, and they have fewer teeth than most marsupials. Both their upper and lower jaws are equipped with chisel-like incisors and molars for chewing tough plants. Wombats are also master tunnel builders, some of the best diggers in the animal kingdom. Their limbs are short but muscular, with claws on each finger. These strong paws allow them to dig extensive burrow systems. The tunnels can be up to 3 meters wide and over 20 meters long. A wombat family, therefore, lives in rather luxurious underground mansions. During the day, wombats stay hidden in their burrows, resting or sleeping. But as dusk falls, they emerge to stretch their legs and look for food. Wombats often live in large groups, so they need plenty of space. A single group can occupy dozens of hectares. They mark the boundaries of their territory in a rather unusual way, with cubes. Yes, you heard right, cubes. From their armored butts come little poop cubes. To understand the reason behind this strange phenomenon, scientists had to dig deep. Their findings were presented at a special conference in Atlanta. Turns out the wombat's intestines are to blame, or rather, to thank. The structure of their digestive tract includes both rigid and elastic sections, which together mold the feces into near-perfect cubes, about 2 centimeters in size. Wombats proudly stack these poop cubes into little piles, as high as possible. That's how they communicate with one another and mark their territory. But to make bricks, you've got to eat. Wombats are herbivores and love munching on young grasses. They also feast on roots, fruits, moss, and mushrooms. Their eyesight isn't the best, but their sense of smell is excellent, perfect for foraging at night. Now, although wombats have a relatively slow metabolism, it's incredibly efficient. It takes them about 2 weeks to fully digest their food. They're among the most water-efficient mammals on Earth, true masters of conservation. So, they eat, they sleep. And now let's talk about how wombats reproduce. They don't follow strict seasons. They breed whenever they feel like it. However, in drier regions, reproduction can become seasonal due to environmental pressures. As marsupials, wombats carry their young in pouches. But here's the twist. The wombat pouch faces backwards. Why? Because wombats are enthusiastic diggers, and a forward-facing pouch would fill with dirt. This way, the babies stay clean and safe. safe, and digging remains practical. Once pregnant, the female wombat's gestation lasts about 3 weeks. Typically, only one baby is born. Wombats are simply not built to raise litters. The newborn stays in the pouch for around 8 months, receiving constant care from the mother. Even after leaving the pouch, the young wombat sticks close to mom for up to a year, until reaching sexual maturity. In the wild, wombats live up to 15 years. In captivity, and with proper care and diet, they can live as long as 25 years. Out in nature, wombats have very few natural enemies. They may seem chill and cuddly, but when it comes to defending their territory, wombats can become downright ferocious. If threatened, a wombat will brace itself, sway its heavy head from side to side, and growl with eerie intensity. This fearless display is often enough to scare off predators. But if intimidation fails, wombats don't hesitate to charge first, using their rock-solid heads as battering rams. And if that doesn't work, well, you already know what that armored backside can do. One well-timed sit-down, and any Aussie hooligan is flattened on the spot. Still, despite having few natural threats, wombats today are critically underpopulated. Why? First, when European settlers arrived, they cleared massive areas of land, destroying wombat habitats. Second, they brought along domestic animals that competed with wombats for food and shelter. And third, the settlers hunted wombats. These factors combined to devastate wombat populations, pushing the long-haired wombat species to the brink of extinction. To address this crisis, conservationists established several protected reserves. But saving wombats will require much more from all of us, if we want future generations to witness not just the cubes, but the marvelous creatures who make them. So watch, learn, like, and share this video. It really helps us grow. And don't forget to subscribe. You're watching Planet Earth.